Dear student, today I am going to speak on the topic abnormal uterine action. First of all, we should know brief review of normal uterine contraction. In normal uterine contraction, polarity of uterus means when the upper segment contract, the lower segment relax. Normally, there are two pacemakers, one is situated at each cornu of the uterus. The uterine pacemaker generate uterine contraction in coordinated fashion. Pattern of uterine contraction. Uterine contraction start at cornu, propagate towards lower uterine segment with decrease in the duration and intensity of contraction as it moves away from pacemaker. There are certain parameters of normal uterine contraction which include basal tone, which is about 5 to 20 mm of Sg, peak pressure around 60 mm of Sg, frequency of contraction, adequate uterine contraction are 1 in 3 minutes lasting for 45 seconds. Now come to the definition of abnormal uterine contraction. Any deviation from normal pattern of uterine contraction affecting the normal course of labor is designated as abnormal uterine contraction. Overall labor abnormalities occur in 25% in nulliparous and 10% in multiparous. We should know some term in excessive uterine contraction. Polycystole, contraction more than once every 2 minutes. Hyperstimulation, the above in response to oxytocin. Tetanic uterine contraction, single contraction lasting for more than 3 minutes. Hypertonic uterine contraction, elevated baseline pressure above 20 mm of Hg. Etiology. As the physiology of normal uterine contraction is not fully understood, the causes of its disordered action remain obscure. However, the following clinical conditions are often associated with it. It is prevalent in first birth, especially with elderly women, prolonged pregnancy, over-distension of uterus like twin and fibroids, emotional factors like anxiety and stress, constitutional factor like obesity, contracted pelvis, malpresentation, injudicious administration of sedative, analgesic and oxytocin, premature attempt at vaginal delivery or attempted instrument vaginal delivery under light anesthesia. The following are different variety of abnormal uterine contraction. First of all, each abnormal uterine action with normal polarity, which include hypotonic dysfunction, which is also called uterine inertia. Second one is hypertonic dysfunction, which include precipitate labor and tonic uterine contraction. Second one, abnormal polarity, is also called incoordinated uterine action, which include a spastic lower segment, colicky uterus, asymmetrical uterine action, constriction ring, generalized tonic contraction, cervical dystocia. First of all, we will discuss uterine inertia. Uterine inertia is the commonest type of disordered uterine contraction but is comparatively less serious. It may appear from the beginning of labor or may develop subsequently after variable period of effective contraction. Features of uterine contraction in uterine inertia. Intensity of contraction decreases, duration increases, interval get increases, good relaxation between contraction, general pattern maintained. diagnosis of uterine inertia. Patients feel less pain during contraction on per-abdominal when hand placed over the uterus, easily indentable uterine wall, less hardening of uterus, fetal heart rate normal, fetal parts well palpable. On per-vaginal examination, poor cervical dilatation, associated contracted pelvis, malposition and deflection. Membrane usually remain intact. How will you manage uterine inertia? General measures to keep the morale of the patient. Maternal stress and emotional appear to inhibit uterine contraction through endogenous adrenaline. Avoid supine position. Empty the bladder. Maintain hydration. Active measures include low rupture of membrane followed by oxytocin drip in escalating dose until effective uterine contraction set up. Role of cesarean section. Cesarean section done in uterine inertia when it is associated with contracted pelvis, malpresentation, fetal or maternal distress. Now come to the precipitate labor. A labor is called precipitate when the combined duration of the first and second stage is less than 2 hours. It is common in multipara and may be repetitive. Rapid expulsion is due to combined effect of hyperactive uterine contraction associated with diminished soft tissue resistance. Labor is short as the rate of cervical dilatation is 5 cm per hour or more for the nulliparous women. There are some maternal and fetus risks during precipitate labor. Maternal risks include extensive laceration of cervix, vagina, perineum, postpartum hemorrhage due to subsequent uterine hypotonia, inversion of uterus, uterine rupture, infection, amniotic fluid embolism in fetus, intracranial stress and hemorrhage as no time for molding, direct hit on the skull, bleeding from torn cord. Treatment. The patient having previous history of precipitate labor should be hospitalized prior to labor. During labor, the uterine contraction may be suppressed by administration either magnesium sulfate during contraction. Delivery of head should be controlled. Labral episiotomy should be done, controlled delivery is helpful. Oxytocin augmentation is to be avoided. Now, come to the tonic uterine contraction and retraction. This type of uterine contraction is predominantly due to obstructed labor. Pathological anatomy of uterus. Contraction increase in intensity, duration and frequency with decreased relaxation in between. Retraction continue, progressive thinning and elongation of lower uterine segment and the development of circular groove between upper and lower segment that is called Bandel's ring. This figure showing the pathogenesis of retraction ring. First figure is a figure of normal labor. Second is a late obstruction. Note the circumferential dilatation and progressive stretching of the lower segment with corresponding thickening of the upper segment and rise in the level of retraction ring following obstruction. In primary gravida, further retraction ceases in response to obstruction and labor comes to a standstill state of exhaustion. In multipara, retraction continue with progressive dilatation and thinning of lower uterine segment. Bandel's ring moves towards the umbilicus, rupture of lower uterine segment, fetal jeopardy and death. Clinical feature. Patient is in agony from continuous pain and discomfort and become restless. features of exhaustion and ketoacidosis are evident. Abdominal palpation reveals upper segment is hard, tender, lower segment distended and tender. Groove is seen between the two. Treatment: correction of dehydration and ketoacidosis, adequate pain relief should be given, parenteral antibiotic, exclude rupture of uterus and cesarean delivery in majority of cases. Now come to the incoordinated uterine action. This variety usually appear in active stage of labor. The hypertonic state of uterus arises from any of the conditions such as spastic lower uterine segment, colicky uterus, asymmetrical uterine contraction, constriction ring or generalized tonic contraction of the uterus, and all these states are collectively called incoordinated uterine action. In incoordinated uterine action, new pacemaker appear all over the uterus. Increased frequency and duration of uterine contraction causes a rise in basal tone and thereby diminish circulation in the placental intravillous space. A spastic lower segment. The pattern of uterine contraction include fundal dominance is lacking and often there is a reverse polarity. The pacemaker do not work in rhythm. The lower segment contraction are stronger. Inadequate relaxation in between contraction, basal tone is raised above the critical level of 20 mm of SD. Clinical features. The patient is agony with unbearable pain, referred to the back. There is evidence of dehydration and ketoacidosis. Bladder is frequently distended and often retention of urine. There are premature attempt to bear down. On parabdomen examination, uterine tenderness present, increased uterine contraction with poor relaxation in between. Palpation of fetal part is difficult, fetal distress in the form of fetal tachycardia. On pervaginal examination, cervix poor dilatation, poor descent, meconium stent lichen may be present. Now come to the management. We should first correct the dehydration. We should give analgesics for pain relief, empty the bladder. We should give injectable antibiotics. Most of the patient need to be terminated by cesarean section. Constriction ring. It is also called Schroeder's ring. It may appear in all stages of labor. Localized myometrial contraction form a ring of circular muscle fiber of the uterus. It is situated at the junction of upper and lower segment, usually around constricted part of the fetus. This figure showing the constriction ring causes it may be due to injudicious administration of oxytocin, premature rupture of membrane, premature attempt of instrumental delivery. Features: maternal condition are not affected, fetal distress may occur, ring is not palpable during parabdomen. It is felt in first stage during cesarean section, second stage during forceps application, and third stage during manual removal of placenta. Treatment: delivery is done usually by cesarean section. Ring usually passes off by deepening plane of anesthesia. In case of difficulties, ring is cut vertically to deliver the baby. We should know the difference between constriction ring and retraction ring. Nature. It is manifestation of localized incoordinated uterine contraction. Retraction ring, it is a end result of tonic uterine contraction and retraction. Causes. It may be due to undue irritability of the uterus, retraction ring following obstructed labor. Situation. It is situated usually at the junction of upper and lower uterine segment. Retraction rings always at the junction of upper and lower uterine segment. Uterus upper segment contract, retract with relaxation in between. In retraction ring, tonically contracted upper uterine segment. Lower uterine segment thick and loose. In retraction ring, lower uterine segment thinned out. In constriction ring, maternal condition always unaffected unless labor is prolonged. In retraction ring, maternal exhaustion and sepsis appears early. Ring is not felt on perabdomen. In retraction ring, ring is felt as a group. On pervaginal examination, ring can be felt usually everywhere. In retraction ring, cannot be felt on pervaginal examination. Now, come to the cervical dystocia. Cervical dystocia means failure of progressive cervical dilatation. It is mainly two types, primary cervical dystocia and secondary cervical dystocia. Primary cervical dystocia is maybe due to first birth when externals fails to dilate, rigid cervix, inefficient uterine contraction, malpresentation and malposition. Secondary due to excessive scarring or rigidity of cervix from previous operation or disease, post-delivery or cervical cancer. How will you manage cervical dystocia? If only the thin rim of cervix is left behind, it is pushed up manually during contraction. If cervix is thin but only half dilated, dorsal incision is given at 2 o'clock and 10 o'clock position, followed by forceps or ventose extraction. Now come to the generalized tonic contraction. It is also called uterine tetany. No physiological differentiation between active upper segment and passive lower segment. Pronounced retraction occurs involving the whole of the uterus up to the internal os. Whole uterus undergo a tonic muscular spasm holding the fetus inside. This picture showing the generalized tonic contraction of the uterus. It may be due to CPD, the obstruction, or injudicious use of oxytocin. Features. On perabdominal examination, uterus is smaller in size, tense and tender. Fetal parts are not palpable. Fetal hearts are not audible. On pervaginal examination, dry, edematous vagina, jammed head with big caput. Treatment. You should first correct the dehydration and ketoacidosis by rapid infusion of Ringer solution, antibiotics to control infection, analgesics for adequate pain relief, tocolytic agent, for example, terbutaline 0.25 mg subcutaneously. Cesarean delivery is done in majority of cases. Thank you, student.